You're listening to the Spend 10K a Day podcast, brought to you by the performance marketing experts at Mute6. This is your source for cutting-edge insight into the world of online advertising from the team with more Facebook case studies than any other agency on the planet. Here are your hosts, Steve Wise and Stuart Anderson.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the Spend 10K a Day podcast. Maybe we should actually call it, because of the time of year, the Spend As Much As God-Awful Humanly Possible Without Losing Money podcast.
I think we probably just want to keep it to Spend 10K a Day, just to keep it kind of short. But I like where your head's at. People are spending a lot of money these days, Steve. What is the latest from Facebook about new features? What do we got?
So, couple new features that Facebook released in regards to the audiences. Now Facebook is continuously allowing us new ways to target audiences. So they have this new thing called targeting users through dwell time. The word dwell time, I love the way they word these new audience features.
Yeah.
But what they mean by dwell time is you want to target people who've seen your ads but haven't take action. And what this means is these are users that have actually, you know, seen your ads multiple times, whether it's a blog post that you're running sponsored, whether it's an organic post, but for whatever reason haven't taken any action. And this is kind of like interesting, because I'm already thinking of like unique, pretty cool ways of leveraging this feature in custom audiences, especially when the goal of most of the campaigns that we run is we want to drive new customers. The word new.
Yeah. I mean, this is, for lack of it, this is a lurker audience. This is the people that are lurking on the feed. They're looking at the ad, regardless of what type it is, and they're thinking about taking an action. They're like kind of interested, but they don't know what they want to do. I think it's a really innovative feature that Facebook's added that gives people another angle to target people in terms of, you know, widening that top of funnel audience. It's like how wide do we want to go? You know, we have people who, you know, take the action of clicking a link or watching a video or engaging with the post. Now it's like, oh, do we want to go a little bit wider and take people who haven't done any of those things but are spending time looking at the ad? I think it's just it's great because it's another option. And, you know, having more options, you know, never a bad thing when you're an advertiser.
Yep. As a marketer, I'm always thinking about how do we get these lookalike 8s, lookalike 9s, lookalike 10s to convert better? How do we turn these, you know, really cold, big, wide gap audiences into great converting, great engaging audiences? So the way I'm using this feature is I'm actually going to start building custom audiences out of it for my top lookalike, you know, prospecting audience, lookalike 8s through 10s. And what I'm going to do is, you know, if I'm just thinking ways to tinker with the features, I'm going to start running, you know, these higher end lookalike audiences with, you know, of my purchasers, of people who view content, of people who add to carts. And then I'm going to start excluding them from my main prospecting campaigns. Because if I know these people are lurkers and I know that, you know, they're not clicking on my normal ads or they're not clicking on my posts, I know that I have to engage them in a unique way. I don't want to keep slamming them with ads because it costs me a lot of money to slam these lurkers with ads. So my goal is I want to actually build custom audiences out around the people who lurk but don't actually interact. And another interesting angle of you know, what we've been testing out over the last couple of days is actually running conversion objective impressions, you know, and actually trying to get all these lurkers out of our audiences by running, you know, really cheap impression-based, impression-focused ads around reach to get these users out of our best, you know, audiences. Because we don't want to tell Facebook to target these users. We don't want them in our audiences. If we're serving them 8, 10, 11 ads and they're not clicking, engaging, liking, well, they're not only really bringing down the quality score of our ads, but they're also, you know, making us lose money in our campaigns.
Yeah, I mean, you brought up a really good point there. I think, you know, one thing that's going through my head listening to you talk is like, obviously it's going to differ for every type of business, but if I'm an advertiser and I'm noticing there's a lot of people that are, you know, or I'm building up this lurker audience, this dwell time audience, what are the things I am going to show those people in a campaign once we segment them off and into their own like audience? If I'm creating a new campaign, trying to engage those people and finally get them to not lurk, finally get them to take action, what type of content, you know, in general might work for those people?
That's a good question. Maybe, you know, running text overlays on top of your videos. A lot of people are just saying, I need video content. They're not running any text overlays on top of their videos. Maybe start building different types of explainer videos to really explain the product. Or maybe, you know, start direct linking to content. Maybe the reason they're not clicking and engaging is because you're trying to be too direct response heavy with your ads. So You know, I think just thinking about it differently is, you know, maybe you want to take these dwell time users who've seen your ad, create a new audience for these people, and then start targeting different creative to them and trying to get them into to be converters, because they actually are a part of prospecting audiences that you want to convert. So maybe the trick is to really, you know, try and figure out how do you use different types of creative to get these people to engage.
Yeah, there's a really good point. So, I mean, my takeaway is there is, like, you know, you obviously want to test creative, which is, you know, good tactically for any situation. But you also want to maybe reduce the ask. You know, if somebody is, you know, lurking, maybe instead of driving them to a product page or a landing page, squeeze page, whatever, it's driving them to content, as you said. You know, trying to engage them at a higher point in the funnel.
Yeah, totally. And secondly, which we haven't mentioned, the second part of this great debate of new Facebook audience features is now we're actually able to target people who share our content.
Yeah.
So, you know, back in the day, we used to run these little ads that would be like this or share this, and, you know, where you actually would call use that as a call to action, the text above the image. And, you know, very soon Facebook saw that and they're like, oh, you're trying to game our system and really, you know, get very cheap, you know, post engagements to be able and then, you know, to be able to actually get people to click. So they won't let those ads get approved anymore, especially for content sites that would that wanted to generate really cheap engagements. So now Facebook, though, is allowing you to build audiences specifically around people who share stuff.
Yeah.
Which is kind of cool, because now if you have content that you really want it, that's really viral, that's really engaging for your brand, now you could run campaigns around page post engagement.
Yeah.
Page post engagement. There we go. And now we're actually able to get people to share our content, then remarket to our sharers.
Yeah. It's a highly engaged audience. It's a really great to segment off. And there's creative stuff you can do with that too. If you have a whole audience of people that, you know, aren't just really buyers, they're enthusiasts, they're promoters, they're people that really believe not just in like maybe a product that you're selling, but they believe in you. They're sharing your content. I mean, I love being able to kind of segment those people off and deliver targeted messaging to them. Maybe it's, you know, you can market your loyalty program to them, an affiliate program perhaps, or just, you know, like offering them, you know, premium content, exclusive stuff in an ad. That'd be probably pretty exciting if somebody's like super engaged with your brand.
Yeah. Remember, these sharers are people who are going to generate free clicks to your, you know, they're going to generate what we call social clicks. So, you know, the way to think about these, you know, these sharer audiences that we're going to start building is that, you know, we're going to generate a lot of virality with the content that we're producing. So maybe one strategy, which we already started mapping out in our little mind map with our campaign team, is to really start running our best content that we produce in-house. You know, when we launch maybe a holiday ad, maybe we're launching it 2 weeks before, we're running, we're trying to get people to share the content initially, trying to build an audience of sharers so that when we're, you know, when we come up with more content, we're going to start releasing this to our sharing audiences and just try and get them to share. And then the next step is, you know, we're obviously going to keep targeting those sharers with new content, really generate a crap load of viral clicks and social proof on those ads. So really, you know, the sharers are the people who are, you know, the early trendsetters, the people that really, you know, engage with your brand and really understand it. And we really want to engage them with unique brandable content.
Yeah, that's awesome. So, you know, I think we'll take a creative angle here for the last part of the conversation. Is obviously these are two new features. Right now we are going into the holiday season. You know, what are some creative ways that, you know, we advertisers can use these two new features to get better results during the holiday period?
Cool. So that is true. We are going in the holiday season. What are we? 2 weeks away from the illustrious Black Friday, the day after Thanksgiving. We're all full. Now we're ready to spend our money. You know, so I guess one of the features that I really stress to people is have a strategy around price testing. Don't start your deals. Don't start discounting too early in the process. Because remember, you want to have the deal that, or the Black Friday special that you're running to be monumental, to be to make a difference, to get people to really stop and really be like, wow, that's really interesting. So I urge people to really try and make their products work currently before the holidays without discounting. Keep testing new creatives. Start reading the comments of the ads. Start understanding the expectations and the solutions you're providing to customers. And then once leading up to Black Friday, have another strategy around doing small amount of discounting. And then to the point of the peak when Black Friday happens, now you're getting something that's, wow, I've never seen it before. I've never seen it 40% off. That's amazing. I've never seen free shipping. And just remember to make this, if you are discounting, make this a moment that people are going to remember and get them to buy in the moment.
Yeah. No, that sounds good. Steve, you got any last thoughts about, you know, these new features?
These features are more around really being able to segment audiences and really segment converge objectives inside your audience. I think dwell time is great because it allows us to pull out people who've seen lots of our ads and haven't converted or haven't engaged. I love the dwell time, you know, feature. I think that Facebook is just giving us more and more tools to be able to really, you know, target and narrow down, you know, very large lookalikes. Their system probably already does this, but now they're giving us a little bit more control or perception of control to do this. And then obviously the sharing, you know, being able to build audiences around people who share content. I think that also allows us to build very niche focused audiences, maybe 10, 20,000 people of people that are really into sharing content, generating social buzz. And I think that's something that, you know, is not going to game change your campaigns. Nothing is game changing, but it gives us, you know, a little bit more control over who's receiving our ads and a little bit more control over our budgets.
That sounds great. Well, yeah, thank you for joining us on another episode of the Spend 10K a Day podcast. If you have any questions about Facebook advertising or e-commerce, send them to questions@mute6.com. You can also email me, Stuart Anderson, at stewart@mute6.com, or Steve Weiss, my partner in crime over there, steve@mute6.com. We will see you again next time.
Yep. Thank you so much, guys. Have an awesome holiday season.